بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اهتدى بهديه واتبع سنته وملته إلى يوم الدين. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما تنفعنا به يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. سبحانك لا فهم لنا إلا ما فهمتنا إنك أنت الجواد الكريم. اللهم يا معلم داود علمنا، ويا مفهم سليمان فهمنا. اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا، وأنت تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا. ربي يسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. ربي اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. نبدأ إن شاء الله هذا التدارس رقم 4 فيما يخص تجويد كتاب الله جل وعلا، فنسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يبارك في هذه الخطوات وأن يتقبل منا ومنكم صالح الأعمال، وأن يجعل هذا الرباط إن شاء الله تعالى في سبيل الله، وأن يجعلنا ممن تحفهم الملائكة كما أخبرنا بذلك الحبيب المصطفى عليه الصلاة والسلام. اجتمع قوم في بيت من بيوت الله يتلون كتاب الله ويتدارسونه فيما بينهم إلا نزلت عليهم السكينة وغشيتهم الرحمة وحفتهم الملائكة وذكرهم الله في من عنده. We start inshallah this درس number 4 of تجويد for beginners, and we are all beginners for this كتاب الله سبحانه وتعالى. We hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us sabr to follow this durus and to take benefit from them. We start inshallah by, as in our habit inshallah, by reading a little bit from one of our brothers inshallah, who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him kitab Allah azza wa jal. And after that inshallah we carry on.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إليه يرد علم الساعة، وما تخرج من ثمرات من أكمامها، وما تحمل من أنثى ولا تطع إلا بعلمه، ويوم يناديهم أين شركائي قالوا آذناك ما منا من شهيد. وضل عنهم ما كانوا يدعون من قبل، وظنوا ما لهم من محيص. لا يسأم الإنسان من دعاء الخير وإن مسه الشر فيئوس قنوط. ولئن أذقناه رحمة منا من بعد ضراء مسته ليقولن هذا لي وما أظن الساعة قائمة، ولئن رجعت إلى ربي إن لي عنده للحسنى، فلننبئن الذين كفروا بما عملوا ولنذيقنهم من عذاب غليظ. وإذا أنعمنا على الإنسان أعرض ونأى بجانبه وإذا مسه الشر فذو دعاء عريض. قل أرأيتم إن كان من عند الله ثم كفرتم به من أضل ممن هو في شقاق بعيد. سنريهم آياتنا في الآفاق وفي أنفسهم حتى يتبين لهم أنه الحق، أولم يكف بربك أنه على كل شيء شهيد. ألا إنهم في مرية من لقاء ربهم، ألا إنه بكل شيء محيط.
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله، فتح الله لك ما شاء الله، جزاك الله خير، أحسن الله إليك. ما شاء الله ما شاء الله، جزاك الله خير. قاسم حسن ما شاء الله قرأ علينا برواية حفص من بعض طرق طيبة النشر. So it's رواية حفص, but some ways of رواية حفص as you mentioned before, this دروس. I got many ways of روايه حفص. One of them he is reading with sect. جزاه الله خيرا وتقبل الله منا ومنه. واسال الله سبحانه وتعالى يصلحه ويصلح اولاد المسلمين عامه وان يجعلهم من حماة هذا الدين وحماة كتاب الله جل وعلا. So اخواني دروس الله المستعان. So today ان شاء الله الدرس رقم اربعه. So درس رقم اربعه ان شاء الله تعالى فيما يخص كتاب الاجاده قبل الاجازه في التجويد. وقلنا ان هذا الدرس ان شاء الله سيكون فيه شيء من العربيه ثم شيء من الانجليزيه حسب ما تيسر. كنا قد وقفنا عند باب التجويد، لكن قبل ذلك جرت العاده ان ناتي بحديث نتدارسه فيما بيننا. وحديث اليوم ان شاء الله تعالى في الصحيحين عن الامام البخاري والامام مسلم رحمهم الله تعالى، عن عبد الله بن عمر، عبد الله بن عمرو بن رضي الله عنهما، عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام قال: المسلم من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده، والمهاجر من هجر ما نهى الله عنه. عبد الله بن عمرو رضي الله عنهما mentioned this hadith that the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said: a Muslim is the one from whose tongue and hands the Muslim are safe, and the muhajir, the real immigrant, is the one who refrained from what Allah has forbidden. So those who are looking for hijrah, this is the good hijrah to do. Inshallah ta'ala. We are here, inshallah, to transmit kitab Allah, to transmit Islam to these people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, هو الذي ذرأكم في الأرض وإليه تحشرون. So, ikhwani, we start, inshallah, this dars by, we stopped here about tajweed. قلنا أن التجويد هو ركن من أركان القراءات، لكن قبل ذلك أود أن أطرح عليكم هذه الأسئلة وأقرأ الأسئلة التي بين أيديكم لعلها هنا، فنمر على الأسئلة. الله المستعان. عفوا سوري فور ذات. نقرأ إن شاء الله هذه الأسئلة، نمر عليها جميعا، ثم بعد ذلك So we start by reading these questions that you have in your hand, and during the dars try inshallah to answer these questions, and if you got time by the end, we inshallah we try to answer them all together. So we read them from here. السؤال الأول: أذكر ثلاث تعريفات للقرآن الكريم عند اللغويين وأهل الكلام والفقهاء. Give three definitions of Al-Qur'an al-Kareem from the language scholars, the scholars of the language of the Arabic, the philosophers and the fiqh scholars. ما هو الركن الأساسي للقرآن الكريم عند القراء وما تعريفه؟ What is the main pillar of the Qur'an al-Kareem from the قراءات the قراء point of view? ما الفرق بين الرواية والطريق والوجه عند القراء؟ We passed over these questions, but now we got sheets, so we can answer them inside. الأسئلة قد طرقنا سألناها من قبل، ولكن الآن بما أن الأوراق موجودة بين أيدينا، فمناسبة أننا إن شاء الله تعالى نجيب وهكذا يكون عندنا شيء، فإن توفقنا أو وفقنا فمن الله سبحانه وتعالى، وإن أخطأنا فنصلح أخطأنا إن شاء الله. What is the difference between رواية طريق and the وجه from the قراء point of view? اذكر العدد التقريبي لطرق القرآن الكريم وبأي طريق يقرأ عامة الناس في بلدنا هذا. I don't know if you answered all these questions before or not. شيئان أساسي، عفوا، ما معنى النقل الصوتي للقرآن؟ وصلنا هنا؟ عفوا نحن ما زلنا في اذكر العدد التقريبي لطرق القرآن الكريم وبأي طريق يقرأ عامة الناس في بلدنا هذا. Give a number of the طرق في القرآن الكريم which طريق is mainly read in our actual country. متى جمع القرآن الكريم بين دفتين؟ اصلاح الخطأ، بين دفتين ولما؟ متى جمع القرآن الكريم بين دفتين ولما؟ When for the first time the Quran was collected between two covers and why? You can complete the question, why they did it. ما الفرق بين الجمع الثاني والثالث القرآن الكريم؟ What is the difference between the second collection and the of the Quran Kareem and the third one? من تذكر من كتاب الوحي الأساسيين؟ جزاك الله خير. جزاك الله. شكرا. لماذا أمر سيدنا عثمان رضي الله عنه بحرق ما كتب فيه القرآن الكريم وبالرجوع فقط إلى ما كتبه الصحابة واتفقوا عليه بإمرته؟ وايديد عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنه burn any other books called Mus'haf which was written by others than the companion who were in charge of writing the actual Mus'haf. ما معنى النقل الصوتي للقرآن الكريم؟ What is the vocal transmission of the Quran Karim? شيئان أساسيان ينبني عليهم التجويد، ما هما؟ Maybe this question here last is conform to the last درس and the درس actual one. شيئان أساسيان ينبني عليهم التجويد، ما هما؟ What are the two necessary topics of تجويد؟ ما اللحن الحرام باتفاق وما تعريفه؟ Which kind of لحن or mistake is forbidden by Islam when reading القرآن الكريم؟ Give a definition of it. كيف نتعلم التجويد؟ لو أصلحتم، كيف نتعلم التجويد؟ How do we learn التجويد؟ ماذا تذكر من فضل لحفظ القرآن الكريم مجوداً؟ What reward can you get when you read Quran Karim by heart with تجويد؟ Next question. التجويد أحد الأركان الأساسية. Second sheet here now. التجويد أحد أركان الأساسية ووسيلة من وسائل السبعة لعلم القراءات، والتي منها علم العربية، علم الرسم والضبط القرآني، علم الفرائض، وعلم الأسانيد أو التحريرات، وعلم وعلم وعلم. You have to complete the, يعني املأ الفراغ. التجويد is a crucial part of the قراءات science which include Arabic language science. الرسم how the Quran is written. The knowledge of آيات and their endings, أسانيد and تحريرات, and we need you to complete three others. إن شاء الله by following درس you can answer these questions. أذكر فضلا من فضائل تعلم التجويد. Give some benefits of learning التجويد. Next question. أذكر هديا من اتباع هدي النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام في تعليم الناس القرآن. Give few sunnah or sunan of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام showing how we taught the recitation of Quran Kareem to his how the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام taught the recitation of Quran Kareem to his companion رضي الله عنه. الحروف الأصلية العربية مرتبة هي you have to complete وأي ترتيب هذا؟ يعني الحروف العربية يجب أن تكتبها بترتيب معين وقل لنا أي هذا الترتيب الذي كتبت، ما اسمه هذا، ما اسم هذا الترتيب الذي كتبت. The original letters in Arabic in order are, you have to write them in order and state the name of this order. You've got too many orders of حروف العربية. You have to write there and to tell us which order you wrote there. أذكر خمسة أحرف من الحروف الفرعية العربية. Mention five sub-characters of the Arabic language. Next question, the other side of the page. رتب الحروف العربية حسب الترتيب الهجائي. Give the هجائي order of the Arabic alphabet. ما اسم ترتيب؟ ما اسم الترتيب؟ كان في خطأ هنا. أو ما اسم ترتيب للحروف العربية؟ وهذا الترتيب ضبط يعني بعد الإسلام يعني والإسلام يعني بمعنى رسالة الخاتمة محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام. يعني بعده بسنوات تم ترتيب الحروف العربية بترتيب معين. يعني after the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام around 90 years, the Arabs, the made an order, special order of the alphabet, give the order of the letters, give it there in this empty space. عندما ننطق الحروف المتحركة العربية شطب العبارة الخطأ يحدث تباعد بين طرفي عضو النطق يحدث تقارب بين طرفي عضو النطق. We want you to cross the incorrect sentence. A gap will be produced between the two organs of the pronunciation when we read the حروف عربية with حركة. When we speak the Arabic, please complete the translation. When you read the حروف with حركة, can you please complete it in English? When you read حروف with حركة, which sentence is wrong? A gap will be produced between the two organs of the pronunciation. A collision will happen between the two organs of the pronunciation. Cross the sentence which is not correct, please. And we want you to make an order. I will tell you now, from now, three columns. يعني رتبوا هذه الحروف ب يعني ثلاث يعني خانات تكون هكذا يعني أفقية واحد اثنين ثلاثة ورتبوا بها الحروف حسب زمنها حسب الزمن زمن قراءتها. We want you to make three columns and to put this حروف here one after one. يعني taking in consideration the time to pronounce the letter. It's very important تجويد. When you pronounce some letters are more late than others, or others are quicker than others. So we want you to put in these columns, let's say, for example, first column, quick one. Second column, medium one. Third column, the long حروف. يعني مثلا في الخانة الأولى أو في الإطار الأول يعني وضعوا مثلا الحروف السريعة وبعدها الحروف المتوسطة أو حروف التوسط زمنها متوسط وبعد ذلك يعني في الأخير ضعوا مثلا الحروف الزمنية كما كان شيخنا يقول. كما قلت لكم لا أعرف من أين أتى بهذا التسمية لم أجدها في كتاب ولكن كان يقول هكذا كان يقول في الحروف الزمنية التي يحتاج نطقها إلى زمن. These are the questions please. So inshallah we pray inshallah salat al-maghrib and after that we carry on. But we carry on I think salana. Allah understand. So we stop inshallah here till we pray salat al-maghrib. نصلي إن شاء الله وبعد ذلك إن شاء الله نواصل نحاول نجيب على الأسئلة إن شاء الله مع التدرس. الله الموفق.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله يا الصلاة يا الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استووا واصلوا سووا صفوفكم سند الخلل fill the gaps. Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين ولولا فضل الله عليك ورحمته لهم الطائفة منهم أن يضلوك وما يضلون إلا أنفسهم وما يضرونك من شيء وأنزل الله عليك الكتاب والحكمة وعلمك ما لم تكن تعلم وكان فضل الله عليك عظيما لا خير في كثير من نجواهم إلا من أمر بصدقة أو معروف إلا من أمر بصدقة أو معروف أو إصلاح بين الناس ومن يفعل ذلك ابتغاء مرضات الله فسوف نؤتيه أجرا عظيما ومن يشاقق الرسول من بعد ما تبين له الهدى ويتبع غير سبيل المؤمنين نوله ما تولى ونصله جهنم وساءت مصيرا الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله الله أكبر الله الله الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. إن الله لا يغفر أن يشرك به ويغفر ما دون ذلك لمن يشاء ومن يشرك بالله فقد ضل ضلالا بعيدا إن يدعون من دونه إلا إناثا وإن يدعون إلا شيطانا مريدا لعنه الله وقال لأتخذن من عبادك نصيبا مفروضا ولأضلنهم ولأمنينهم ولآمرنهم فليبتكن آذان الأنعام ولآمرنهم فليغيرن خلق الله ومن يتخذ الشيطان وليا من دون الله فقد خسر خسرانا مبينا يعدهم ويمنيهم وما يعدهم الشيطان إلا غرورا أولئك مأواهم جهنم ولا يجدون عنها محيصا الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله الله أكبر الله الله أكبر الله أكبر الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الله أكبر. استغفر الله. استغفر الله. استغفر الله. اللهم لك السلام. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اهتدى بهديه واتبع سنته إلى يوم الدين. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما تنفعنا به، يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين. So إخواني, we stopped last time about, we talk about تجويد. What's تجويد? And we gave a definition of اللحن, اللحن الجلي and اللحن الخفي. And we say that اللحن الجلي, not big mistakes when you transform a letter, you know, change the letter, the مخرج of the letter, you change the big صفه that changing completely the letter. In this time, we enter in اللحن الجلي. And it's haram, majority of most scholars, let's say, all scholars, they say it's haram to transform a letter in Quran Kareem. That's اللحن الجلي. At اللحن الخفي, اللحن, when it's concerning some rules of تجويد or قراءات, تحريرات القراءات. And we gave example of غنّة و مقادير المدود of some letters, for example, they read differently depending on the way you are reading. That's اللحن الخفي. العلماء they say that's right for normal Muslims. But for the scholars of قراءات, طلبة العلم, etc., it's haram for them. Why it's haram? Because who is going to transmit the Quran? Who is going to protect the Quran if not these people? It's haram عند العلماء, كما قال أهل العلم. So it's very important to know this, especially the people who follow القراءات, who follow, etc. It's very important because they got a responsibility on them. ليعلم هذا يعني طلبة العلم أنهم يتحملون مسؤولية. وليس فقط الإنسان قرأ على الشيخ وانتهى الأمر، فهذه مسؤولية أمانة من الله سبحانه وتعالى على ظهورهم حتى يحموا هذا الكتاب، لأن القرآن لا بد وأن يحمى بنا. Who is going to protect the Quran if he's not Muslims? We are not asking the people outside to protect the Quran Kareem, but we Muslims have to protect it. And especially those who follow القراءات, etc., who follow this علم, they should read properly because they got أمانة, they got responsibility on them. So we came off from that topic about تجويد, what is it, اللحن الجلي, اللحن الخفي, and we follow, inshallah, we follow now with some definitions. So we say, العلماء, they say that التجويد is a part, يعني هو التجويد أحد الأركان الأساسية ووسيلة من وسائل السبعة لعلم القراءات. علم القراءات, they say that got seven topics, seven subjects. One of them, let's put them in order, and you don't forget your sheets. First one is علم العربية والتي بها يقرأ القرآن ويفهم القرآن. بل قالوا أن جل علوم القرآن الكريم وكثير من مباحث علم التجويد والقراءات هي مباحث لغوية. Really, when Arabic, and it's the, as you know, it's the language that Allah Subhanahu wa Taala chose to transmit the message, and we talk about this in the first dars too much. And the Arabic, the علم of Arabic, it's very important for, and it's a big pillar of علم القراءات. The next one is الرسم والضبط القرآني. How you write مصحف and how you know that's الرسم, that like the skeletons without any حركة, without nothing, how to write it and how to make it easy for reading. ضبط, we add some things. Maybe our time is very known by colors. They put تجويد rules in the مصحف. It wasn't in the time before. ضبط, he made easy Quran, he made easy Quran to read for the people. That's فتحة, كسرة, all the dots, etc. All it was added to مصحف. If you take everything, just you leave the skeleton without nothing, that's what الصحابة wrote, رضي الله عنهم. After that, العلماء, they made added something to help people reading Quran Kareem. So it's entering ضبط, Quran Kareem. That's another علم as well. And depending on the people who make this dabt. As I knew my mashayikh, etc., now many of them, they are not anymore in this big place that they print mushaf. But we took many rules about from them how to make dabt of Quran Kareem. You have to know how they made it. Sometimes they explain by the end of the mushaf how they made that dabt. But it's ilm of ilm qara'at. The next ilm, or the third one, is ilm al-fawasil. Where to stop, where to make them, you know, that's a number, as well as it's a ilm. It's not just you come and you put it where you want. It's a ilm al-fawasil. And it's very important in some qara'at. Because if you got qira, if you got there a number, if you got ayah there, you read it with manner. If it's not, you read it with different manners. And طلبة في علم قراءات يعرفون هذا الشيء. علم الفواصل علم أيضا مهم في وركن من أركان علم القراءات. The fourth topic of علم القراءات, the fourth subject is تجويد itself. والتجويد you know is how to bring حروف to know the مخارج of حروف صفاتها and everything which is related to them and especially where the حروف are near each other. لما عندما تختلط الحروف مع بعضها وما يتعلق بها فيدخل في علمي التجويد. Some people sometimes they add the next topic which is the fifth one الوقف والابتداء they add it in تجويد as well. But in general it's taken off from تجويد الوقف والابتداء where to stop where to start. Because got some ayat, long ayat, etc. If you stop sometime, you make catastrophe, you know. الوقف والابتداء علم جميل جدا وفي حقيقة نسمع العجيب. We hear different things from the people when they're reading Quran Kareem. If you don't know the meaning, just follow what ulama they put, where to stop, where to start. If you read in front of Sheikh in general, Sheikh will tell you where to stop, where to start if you make a mistake. In general, otherwise, it's all right, يعني. الوقف والابتداء got many books, many علماء وفقه الابتداء يعني it's a علم like independent for itself علم الوقف والابتداء but many people they operate in التجويد. علم الأسانيد والتحريرات وهو الطرق الموصلة إلى القرآن الكريم وهو من أعظم ما يحتاج إليه. الأسانيد والتحريرات يعني مي ما سفريزم ما يشيخ تل رسول الله عليه الصلاة والسلام that chain of narrators and التحريرات what you read, what you have not to read and they talk about this about العلم when we talk about اللحن الخفي عندما تكلمنا عن اللحن الخفي تكلمنا عن الأسانيد والتحريرات ودورها وقيمتها. As I told you, it's very important for the scholars of قراءات, the people who want really to read the Quran properly, to know what they're reading. That's that changed from us to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. It's around, you know, 26, 27, 28, 30, depending on Sheikh, where sometimes you don't meet the Sheikh you want, etc. But in general, it's around that average. Let's say here about 1,500, put in each 100 one Sheikh. It give you around 30. That's the average of Mashaykh between us and the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. ثم كذلك علم الابتداء والختم. How to start, how to finish Quran Kareem. It's الختم, الابتداء والختم. How to make استعاذة, how which sort of استعاذة, if I say for example, أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم, if I say أعوذ بالله العظيم من الشيطان الرجيم, can I say أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, etc. Got different manners, can I say for example, الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, or something like that. You got that's how to start, how to stop, and sometimes you put it as a علم outside of التجويد, sometimes you enter it in قراءات in general, but in قراءات it's included 100%. So all this it's included in قراءات, but sometimes you enter this number six, علم الابتداء والختم, number seven, number five and four. Some people they enter them in one subject and they call it تجويد, but they are independent normally. Each one is independent from the other. ما أدري هل سمع الباقون أم لا. فقلنا أنها التجويد يدخلون فيه الوقف والابتداء ويدخلون فيه احيانا الابتداء والختم. ثم فضل تعلم التجويد. What reward can I get when I read Quran properly with التجويد? You have to know that the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, الصحابة رضي الله عليهم, they don't know anything different from تجويد. They read normally like this. Some people they said, why you make it difficult, غنى التنوين, etc. You make it hard. Did the Prophet learn all this? إخواني, ذيك اللغة كانت لغة النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. يقرؤونها بسليقة. هكذا كانوا يقرؤون. لا يعرفون شيئا غيرها. فيعرف لغتهم كانت سليمة. فمحتاجوا في حقيقة إلى ضبط هذا العلم. محتاج العلماء إلى ضبط هذا العلم. إلا بعد أن دخل اللحن وبدأ الناس يلحنون. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام and Sahaba, they took Arabic, pure Arabic. They don't need any to teach them. You know, they hear something 100%, it's 100% correct. They don't need anyone to teach them الغنات, مدود, etc. They read it like this. That's their language. Normally, they speak pure Arabic. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he never made a mistake in the language in all his life. يعني لغته هكذا لغتهم سليمة. فمن فضائل التجويد إخواني, maybe to give us some, to push us to make صبر, like we are here and those watching us, يعني الصبر to stay and to make تعلم, like this hadith here, we can bring everything, but some of them like this, كما قال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام, خيركم وفي رواية أفضل إن أفضلكم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه. The best among you, Muslim. من تعلم القرآن, who learn the Quran Kareem and teach it to others. You learn Quran properly, يعني clearly, and you teach it to others. You transmit it to others. You know, إخواني, many Muslims, they are doing too many good actions. But you say, لا memorize the Quran, mashallah, and you read with tajweed, and best of the Muslims. والله, إخواني, this task needs sabr, يعني needs sabr, etc. Need the first thing is to have sabr to sit in front of Sheikh to read long time. Maybe Sheikh is not every time as you wish. But you need sabr from Sheikh and from the student. فلذلك النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام يعني رغب لنا في ذلك. يقال لصاحب القرآن يوم القيامة اقرأ ورقة ورتل كما كنت ترتل في الدنيا فإن منزلتك عند آخر آية كنت تقرأها. As you read ترتيل, the book that you read in الدنيا and the آخرة is كتاب الله عز وجل. The book that you read here and hereafter is كتاب الله. And you read with ترتيل, you read التجويد here, you read الترتيل and تجويد there, but be careful there. Any آية you read, it's a step in جنة. And the steps, you know, إخواني, like you see the stars, like you see the moon, that's very far from each other. Like أمنا عائشة رضي الله عنها, she said, إن منازل الجنة بمقدار عد آيات القرآن. The steps or the level of جنة is like the number of آيات based on this hadith رضي الله عنها. Because each آية you read بالترتيل والتجويد, it's a step in جنة. It's not a house, you know, three bedrooms, you know. Maybe you pass all your life to buy one. But إخواني, just a step in جنة, just one آية. والله العظيم, ما شاء الله, يعني that's a good reward, والله. And إخواني, الله سبحانه وتعالى protect the people who يقرأون القرآن الكريم بتجويد وبترتيله كما أنزله الله سبحانه وتعالى. As Allah سبحانه وتعالى protect his كتاب, he protect these people. And in general, we say this to those who maybe sometimes they are not good with Muslims, that Muslims, when they are in a place, subhanAllah, Allah protected, especially those حفظة كتاب الله عز وجل. Allah عز وجل said, إنا نحن نزلنا الذكرى وإنا له لحافظون. Allah يعني revealed this كتاب, Allah will protect it. But protected by who? By Muslims, correct? He's not going to protect it by someone who maybe he don't like it, burn it, or maybe he threw it with something. But he will protect it by Muslims, by us. And Allah protect that kitab, protect the place where you are, protect, inshallah ta'ala, the country where we are, inshallah ta'ala. الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ يَتْلُونَهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the kitab to some people, gave them, and they take it with consideration, properly, they read it properly. أُولَٰئِكَ يُؤْمِنُونَ يَتْلُونَهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ. They read it properly as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this kitab. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said with Amr, وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا. Read this kitab, read the Quran Kareem with tartil, with tajweed, so we can distinguish each letter properly. You don't make mixture of the letters, you don't destroy them, and so on and so forth. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَوْلَا نَزِّلَ عَلَيْهِ الْقُرْآنُ جُمْلَةً وَاحِدَةً كَذَلِكَ لِيُثَبِّتَ بِهِ فُؤَادَكَ وَرَتَّلْنَاهُ تَرْتِيلًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it to be read like this. And imagine, ikhwani, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my God and the Lord of all this dunya, who made this Quran to be read like this. And the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, don't forget your sheets, huh? And Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, كان هذا من هديه. Every time the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam used to read this Quran as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked him to do. وقرآنا فرقناه لتقرأه على الناس على مكث ونزلناه تنزيلا. To read it properly with tartil, etc., so the people can hear it properly. Nothing will be missed from it. Well, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم sometimes, إخواني, used to خطبة كاملة يكون مثلا فيها آية سورة, يقرأ سورة. He used sometimes in منبر to read سورة, like سورة قاف, etc. He got many hadith about that. He read one سورة in الخطبة. So the people, they learned that سورة from النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام in منبر. And in da'wah, and when he sent letters and so on. And many times in any tribe who entered in Islam, they sent too many of his sahaba to teach the people Quran straight away. And you know, when Medina, some people entered in Islam, he sent who? Mus'ab alayhi kadhalik, to teach the people Quran Kareem. So this is the first task the Prophet have to make when the Muslims enter in Islam, they sent someone to teach them the Quran Kareem, to read the Quran properly, to link them with Quran Kareem. إخواني, that's the reward, that some reward that we get from when we read Al-Quran Kareem properly. This Quran, إخواني, is revealed in Arabic, as you know. And ayat is ayat, some number of ayat, like it looks like sentences. Sometimes you got some sentences inside, got words inside, and the word is a number of letters. And this letter that we are going to discuss about here. يعني القرآن كما لا يخفى عليكم آيات والآيات كلمات والكلمات هذه مجموعة من الحروف وهذا الحرف الذي نركز عليه نحن في تدارسنا هذا. عند أحكام التجويد يقول after that when you read مخارج عن الصفات يقول some small أحكام تجويد they come like النون الساكنة التنوين ميم ساكنة and النون مشددتين and so on لام ال ولام تعريف and so on when you got similar letters when they meet each other and so on you got small أحكام they come after that but everything is based on الحروف. And I remember, إخواني, when our Sheikh said, when you get إجازة, you got everything finished with him, he told us, لا تنسوا الحروف. Don't forget the حروف. Don't say, because now I got إجازة, يا شيخ, ما شاء الله, استغفر الله. يعني. And you say, I'm going to sleep. Now he said, الحروف, you have to, like you start the lowest level in your life to read الحروف properly. It means be careful about حروف. Don't miss them. Every time, check yourself that you read حروف properly. That's the يعني, one of the advice that one of our Sheikh يعني, told us. جزاه الله خير. These حروف, إخواني, got حروف أصلية, original characters, that they are here. And هذه حروف الأصلية العربية. Got some حروف أصلية, يعني هكذا, يعني أصلاً موجودة في العربية. وفي حروف فرعية. Got some other حروف, we got to talk about them. Like this, you know, when you see, they put them in this order. This order, we call it al-tartib al-hijai. Al-tartib what? Al-hijai. Like your alphabet, yani order. And this order, إخواني, it comes around 90 of Hijrat Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. One by a linguistic man, you call it Nasr ibn Asim al-Laythi. During the Imara of al-Hajjaj ibn Yusuf al-Thaqafi. They put this order because they need it, because they've seen many people, they make mistakes, etc. Before, you don't have dots. And they put them like this, and they put dots for them and to make distinction of the حروف that they got same design. الحروف التي تشتبه بعضهاش على مع بعضها. تشوف الحروف. وطبعا جعل الألف أول حرف يخرج من الحلق. ثم بعد ذلك الباء والتاء والثاء نفس الصورة. ثم الجيم والحاء والخاء نفس الصورة. النقط هي التي تفرق بينها والذال والذال والراء والزاي والسين والشين وهكذا والصاد والضاد يعني على هذا الترتيب. This ترتيب إخواني which is used in dictionary, which is used in national union, etc. which is recognized like say internationally. This ترتيب الهجائي. It was what which year he told you around 90 of هجرة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. When they start to think, Arabs start to think about their language, because many people to transform it. You know, Islam around the globe, etc. So the people start to make mistakes. Arabs themselves start to make mistakes because they mix it with many other non-Arabs. So they start to make mistakes. They start to think about their language. One of the that he made this person, Jazallah Khairan, and he put them in this order, which is actually used in dictionary. You find this called Tartib al-Hijai. This tartib, it's after this tartib. You got two tartib of the like this, but this is the main one. We call it tartib al-abajadi, like the name abajad. Start first word. Abajad hawwaz hutti kalamun sa'fas qarashat thakhad dha'dha. So tartib is abaja. This is what we use in general. هذا tartib we didn't استعمله. عندما نريد مثلا أن نعد شيئا نقول مثلا وفعلت كذا وكذا وكذا الأول آ ثاني باء ثاني جيم هكذا like bowling list you want to make the bowling list in Arabic in general they made it with this order we call it ترتيب which ترتيب we call it ترتيب أبجدي following the first word this word got many explanations some Arabs they make explanation they said for example أبجد it means أخذ هوز ركب حطي وقف كلام أصبح متعلما صعفص أني أسرح في التعلم إكسترا and they gave some meaning other they said that's the name of some tribes of during the time of Nabi Allah Shu'aib يعني before thousand to no hundred of years before نبي الله محمد عليه الصلاة والسلام. So this is the old tartib that is used, but mainly this tartib, إخواني, is used in قراءات. It's very important this tartib. If you don't know it, maybe you don't know too many things in قراءات. We talk about قراءات, we don't talk about تجويد, but قراءات. We got another tartib of حروف العربية by I don't know if you put it here, but I don't want to make it too much hard. No, leave it there. Tartib, we give the way to each harf. Like alif is one, ba is two, ha, jim is three. Follow the tartib abjadi. They gave them each harf, they gave them a weight. And we call it in hisab al-jummal. It's very important in the poem. It's like a code. They put it in the code of the poem, etc. Like, for example, in the poem of Tahfat al-Atfal that many people didn't know. He said, أبياتها ند بدال ذي النهى. That's ند بدال ذي النهى. Each harf, he got a weight. And from there, I know how many lines of the poem is there. And he put dates as well with this code, etc. We don't want to put too much stress in this. But let's start by the important things, inshallah, for us. Is this. الظاهرة الصوتية بالتباعد والتلاحم. If you understand this, many things, inshallah, will be easy for us when we start تجويد. You know the sound here, when you get a hammer, for example, you hit something, you get a sound. Or you get an explosion, let's say a rock destroyed, like it give a sound. So, هذه الظاهرة الصوتية تقع بالتباعد أو التلاحم. بعض علماء المسلمين, as I remember maybe Ibn Sina and others, they call it القرع والقلع. القرع and القلع, you go out from there. And you got between them when something vibrating, you know, vibrating, like this, give a sound as well. Because قلع, قرع, قلع, قلع, is repeated many times, so give us sound. It's very important, إخواني, to know this. Like, for example, Hamza. When I read Hamza, I close the vocal nerves here. So I close it. I give a sound like this. And when I want to say, for example, fatha, like this. Give a sound, but opening. This one closing, this one opening. Like I'm up, I close my lips, give a sound. When I open it, ba. That's very important now. When I make sukun, I bring the two organs of what you're talking with, I close them. When I make haraka, I open them. Is it clear or not? نعم. إذن هذه الظاهرة ظاهرة الصوتية مهمة جدا في 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 التجويد. I don't want to enter in physics, etc. to tell you how the transmission is made, etc. Leave it that for the people of that subject. But it's very important, as Ibn Sina, رحمه الله, maybe translate in English, Avicenna, something like that. Who talk about this subject many years before, and it's very important for us to know in tajweed. As I told you, when you make sukun, you close the organ. When you make haraka, you open them. It's very important to know. And it's very important to know why, because it gave us ideas about ترتيب الحروف العربية بالنظر إلى أزمنة نطق الحروف. And don't forget your sheet for this. When you get فتحة, با, بو, بي. Can you see that it goes same time? با, بو, بي. ما, مو, مي. فخرج, فخرج. خمسه. If you read خمسه, خمسه, you see now I'm reading خمسه. Like I make sukun on the second harf. Now it should be the same. خمسه فقتل. And the same movement, same حركة, same time. يأمركم, يأمركم برسولنا. If I'm reading يأمركم, it's easy, isn't it? It's small things, إخوان. يأمركم. إن الله يأمركم. يأمركم. How precise is this Quran, إخواني? That's reading. It should be قراءة أبو عمر. You know, you may be many people don't take in consideration, don't see any difference between them. But قراءة المشايخ study know it. If you read يأمركم, you are reading أبو عمر. قرات ابو عمرو اوريامركم كوز ابو عمرو يريد يدير اختلاس يقول اختلاس يو دونت ميك حركه فول حركه يو تيك ات ليتل بيت تيك ات ليتل بيت يو تيك ثيرد اوف ات يامركم اي وانت ليتل بيت ا كويك فور را يامركم ذات يقول اختلاس قرات ويامركم same thing برسولنا برسولنا فهم ريد برسولنا it looks like قرات ابو عمرو يسي برسلنا برسولنا so when you got this sort of thing what you have to protect in تجويد نحرص على تسوية أزمنة الحروف you have to give the same time for each حرف إخواني التجويد many many problems of تجويد come from this if you don't give the same حركة same time you تجويد will not be correct So we give you us, this is حروف المتحركة. When you got حركة, all حروف عربية, we don't make to put a classification, but it's like an order, another order of حروف. Here, حروف متحركة, all حروف متحركة, they got an order. They got the same time. But when they are with سكون, we have to follow this order. And you remember this hand like this? Yeah. So the, which حروف are here? We are there, the quickest one, حروف سريعة. The حروف سريعة, very quick حروف, حروف أجيد قطين بكت. But when? When they got حركة? No, when they got سكون. We got to got حركة, we said all حروف عربية without distinction, they got same time. الحروف العربية لما تكون متحركة عندها إيش؟ نفس الزمن. ما فيش عربي يتكلم هنا. عندها نفس الزمن إذن ما نتكلم العربية صح أو لأنكم نايمين لا طيب قلنا أن الحروف المتحركة عندها نفس إيش نفس الزمن يعني نفس الزمن فخرج برسولنا you have to bring it like this if you say برسولنا or خرج or something like that أمركم no it's not correct it should be same time for each حرف فخرج but when they go to سكون this is the problem of تجويد here You have to follow this order. If you don't follow this order, your tajweed never will be correct. Be sure, take it from me. Unless Sheikh is sleeping. when you read in front of him. But you have to follow this order. Ajid qatin bakat, quickest huruf. Lin Umar, the medium one. Baqi al-huruf, the remaining huruf, that's the longest huruf in Arabic. You have to take them, take your time when you read it, when you read them. Like for example, look the أثخنتموهم شوف أثخنتموهم مثلا الذال إذ تقول look الذال how long it take with me إذ تقول أظفركم and so on let's take some example to read them here ويؤتون look ويؤتون I don't say ويؤتون no I can't do it ويؤتون ويؤتون وتقواها let's read it by order please يلا ويؤتون الهمزة don't stay longer ويؤتون أحسن so you see همزة it's quick is it the next word يا أخي اللي بعده اللي بعده next one وتق look القاف وتق I come I open straight away وتق I don't say وتق No, if I do it, mistake. وتقواها. I come and open. I come to مخرج. I come to the point. Straight away, go back. وتقواها. أحسنت. لي بعدها أستاذنا. أحسنت. يد. Look at that, إخواني. يد. I come and open straight away. This حروف all. أجد قاطين بكت. All of them there. Oh, some of them there. لي بعدها أستاذنا. حبل. You say حبل. I don't say حبل. No, حبل. Quick, go open straight away. حبل لبعدها. Next one, please. ما طلعي. You see, ما طلعي. Now, حروف التوسط. Next line, please. Next word, please. Who can see the next line? يا شيخنا خليك انت. الشباب الاخرين. Next word, please. If you can. قل. I have to say like, قل. Take your time for it. قل أعوذ. I say قل أعوذ. الانسان ذوق العلم اخواني تعبدون نسيت تعبدون خطا صح تعبدون اللي بعدها Yeah, upstairs, take some answer, some reading, please, from these three lines. جزاكم الله خير. أحسنت. رسيل ميم. وامرأته. Next. You can see. Who can see? Can you? This one. أيوة. But one hand. Why you are pressing? One hand. They didn't put it, but he got إظهار. You forgot this one as well to put it. وانحر إن look وانحر إن آناء حروف what do you call it in Arabic ما اسمه ما شاء الله زمنية it means what it takes long time to bring them you have to put to go with them don't they are not happy they want you to take you with you no they want to take you a little bit with them الوسواس لام از ميديوم الوسواس تفضل الوسواس الوسواس ما شاء الله عليك احسن اللي بعدها next one this one I can't hear هذه مهمة جدا يلا قولوا لي ايش هنا شفتوا هذا نايما what you have here اخواني اجد قطين بكت now don't tell me you don't know it it's here now that's my hand scant هذه put there really so ترتيب الحروف العربية بالنظر لأزمنة نطق الحروف the order of Arabic letters in relation to the time of the letter's pronunciation. So remember them. It's very important, ikhwani. Every time I seen some brothers, mashallah, they put it in their books or they're in Quran by the Pravidian, for example. Every time they see the huruf when they are reading. It's very important. If you don't take it in consideration, Allah take it from me, you're never going to bring tajweed properly because it's basics of the basics. It's very important to know it. After المخارج إن شاء الله will be good etc. That's very important to know. الحروف الفرعية. You got some حروف إخواني. They are not originally there. We call them subsidiary letters between they are not originally in Arabic but they come by combination of makhraj of another letter of another sifa an attribute of another one so they are not حروف أصلية we call it حروف فرعية حروف فرعية how many they are can you see how many can you tell me how many they are كم هي الحروف الفرعية؟ عشرة ربما عشرين شوف جيدا انظر جيدا ها؟ How many؟ الله أكبر. I got something better than. ها؟ But just سبعة. ها؟ كم هنا؟ واحد، اثنين، ثلاثة، أربعة، خمسة، ستة، سبعة. I missed one. Why is that? Should be ثمانية. ثمانية أحرف. ثمانية أحرف. كم هم؟ ثمانية. How many إخواني؟ Eight. Intermediate حرف or subsidiary حرف. Intermediate. They are not really a حرف in Arabic, but it comes by it be near one حرف or take صفة from another حرف with مخرج of another حرف. You got one in حفص. Here got الهمزة المسهلة. We call it in قراءات say بين بين. Between between. Can translate in English like this. Between between. It's not a full همزة. It's not a full همد. It's between them. قلت ها بين بين قلت إن قرأت قلت بين بين or sometimes قلت تسهيل is not too much in حفص in حفص you got one obligatory and you got how many where are people of قرأت here كم هم بوجه ثاني في حفص يعني واحدة ضرورية لابد يادي أعجمي look a ها can you say it all of you please It's very important to tell to my sometimes some students very difficulties to say it. You tell them just you when you see your little adhan Allah this sound that's he this hamza musahala. Correct? Can you say it? Wallahi be sure many people did it with sihir without knowing. They say wa anna look wa anna hada. فإن الله is not full همزة إخواني that's مسهلة they read with سهيل many may be all their life but when I ask them to read سهيل they don't know it فإن is not correct همزة it should be فإن not فإن you understand وأن هذا صراطي مثلا وأن is not good should be وأن not وأن you see many people they read with همزة مسهلة without knowing But with this small thing is protected, إخواني القرآن الكريم. In حفص we read this word only obligatory. We got six word as a second choice in some ways of Quran الكريم in حفص for example. In شاطبية you read both. If you read from ways of شاطبية which is very known in what we read with, you have to read both are correct. It's not you have, but you إبدال first اختيار الذكرين that's إبدال you make ألف. الذكرين or you can read it الذكرين همزة مسهلة قل الذكرين حرم الله أذن الله أذن الآن وقد الآن وقد can you see it واضحة ولا This is Hamza Musahala. And Hafs, you got this one obligatory, you got six as a second choice. But many other qira'at, it's too many. Like in the way it works, like you call Ahl Sama, you call them Ahl Sama if you take off qira'at Rawh. Ahl Sama, you call it mean qira'at Nafi', qira'at Ibn Kathir, qira'at Abu Amr. He got it as well, Ibn Amir. He's not from Ahl Sama. He got too many, especially in Qira'at Hisham, Riwayat Hisham. And you got it in Abu Ja'far. You got it in Ya'qub, especially from the way of Ruwais. So this too many, this he got too many there, because it's easy. But then A'unzila, it's more easy than A'unzila. Because it means make easy that Hamza. This is Harf, between. We say what? Harf Far'i. Let's take a little bit of time, إخواني, outside of الدرس because we of صلاة العشاء and we missed the meal. Can we take till 7 possible for you? ها كان نمشي إلى السابعة ممكن؟ جزاكم الله خير. So the next حرف فرعي is الألف الممالة أو المقللة. الألف what؟ الممالة. In the meantime, إخواني, please if you can take this sheet and see if your name is there. If it's not, please put your name and your email so we can contact you inshallah in the future. جزاكم الله خيرا. And if it's there, take it. If it's something is not wrong, please correct it. And if your name is not there, put it in a new one. We want, inshallah, during درس next درس to make an organization in this درس بارك الله فيك. If your name is not there, please put it in this sheet, this one, the fresh one. Who can be volunteer to turn around? Especially شباب ما شاء الله. If your name is not there, please put it there. If it's there already in the list, please just correct if there is any mistake there. نواصل إخواني بارك الله فيكم وحفظكم الله ورعاكم. الحرف الفرعي الثاني والألف الممالة أو المقللة. So this ألف ممالة أو مقللة. It's between. الألف الممالة. You know إمالة. When you open your mouth, يقول الفتح. You open your mouth. مثلا مجرى. يقول الفتح من قراءة. أي open. فتح. أي يقول فتح الباب. Many people don't know فتح الباب in عربية. What does it mean? فتح. So you mean فتح. You mean you open your mouth up. And مجرى. If I little bit down, يقول التقليل. مجرى. You see مجرى. Little bit. If more than that, مجري. يقول إمالة كبرى. يقول إمالة. That's إمالة إخواني. That exists too many قراءات. In Hafs only got one. This is the word مجريها. مجريها. Can you say it all of you, please? من قراءة حمزة قراءة كسائي قراءة خلف العاشر and from قراءة رواية مدقوان باختلاف he sometimes reads like this sometimes not in قراءة كبرى بشرى look this sound you can say بشرى بشرى بشري can you say بشرى بشرى بشري so it's فتح after the sound بشرى like رواية حس بشرى بشرى like رواية ورش بشرى and بشرى قراءة حمزة and كسائي and خلف عشر so this is ألف ممالة ومقللة so if you read sometimes حفص and you read for example بشراكم or الشيخ no الشيخ someone who don't know too much but then you read بشرى you will not know you don't مقللة you should be up because you're reading فتح you have to open my mouth بشرى if I say بشرى no it's not it's ألف مقللة or ممالة The next حرف إخواني فرعي is صار مشمم صوت الزاي. Only قراءة حمزة يريد قراءة إيه. إن الزراطة. ها؟ الظل. Can you say it? الظل. So if you read, you do read it somewhere, for example, الظا, you read it like the الظل. It's a mistake, يعني. Maybe many people read, for example, when you start off الضاد, when you start off الظا, they read الظل. That's فرح حرف فرعي. يقول لك الصاد المشممة صوت الزاي. In some قراءات in four words صراط الزراط قراءة حمزة or يزور in قراءة حمزة and يقول إن كسائي خلف العاشر and يقول إن رويس أزور قراءة رواية رويس ومن يعقوب قراءة نمبر 8 so الصاد مشمم صوت الزاي إشمام إخواني what does it mean? It means you insert something inside it was صاد I insert like a زاي there inside زاي it gave me الزي سوي حرف فرعي. The next حرف إخواني الألف المفخمة. You know أو. This sound أو. Does it exist in عربية? Does it exist or not? أو في سيد أو. You know it's not in Arabic. So it's حرف فرعي. It's a حرف that ألف that they add inside a صفة. They add an attribute which is تغليظ تفخيم. And give me أو this sound. And it's in general if we follow the alif, we say we follow the letter before. If the letter before is heavy harf, so it's your alif will be heavy. Or if it's weak harf, it will be like for example, ja. How do you say ja? It's ja. But if it's harf heavy like sa, مثلا الصابرين look الص. This sound oh. It's ألف مفخمة because the حرف before is heavy حرف الألف will follow the حرف before we add an attribute to the ألف الياء المشممة صوت الواو it's a حرف فرعي as well it's not origin عربية so many people you tell me that's a high level إخواني no if you know it it's good because you avoid to make mistake in your قراءة if you don't read with you avoid to make mistake with this sort of thing if you know them. Like word qila. The qila originally is qawala. Some qira'at they show this. Like qira'at Kisa'i or Hisham or Riwayat Ruwais. You see, qila. You know, I start by waw, but I finish with ya. Qila. So this kasra we put, or this ya we put inside sawt al-waw, it's ya with ishmam. Ishmam like you smell. You smell it with waw. Huh? You smell it, you put a smell of waw there inside. You call it ishmam. So you put it inside, give another harf, far'i, it's not originally there. Qila. You see how it's? Qila. Can you say just for learning, for our culture? Qila. Qila. Well, the other harf is lam mughalad. This one we use it, we read it in all qira'at, is lam law. Law is not originally in lam. In Arabic you say lam, alif, lam, etc. You read lam. But sometimes you make it heavy in name of Allah, especially in all qira'at. If you got fatha or dhamma before, you say huwa Allahu, abdullahi. But if you got kasra before, bismi lahi. That's the original one. But Allah is added to an intermediate harf. It means a lam, and they add another attribute of taghlid. I make another harf, which is law. Only in the name of Allah. And in riwayah, one only way of riwayat warsh, tariq al-azraq, we read it many times, like salah, dhallah. If you hear someone, don't tell him it's a mistake because it's only in the name of Allah. No, it's in this, only this riwayah, riwayat warsh, from the way of azraq. We make some lam taghlid with conditions. Got some conditions applicable to that. The other harf ra'i is noon al mukhfah. This sound is not an. It's something we merge it inside the letter kameen. It's ta, for example, kon tu. So we add that ghunna there. Kuntum. So ta originally there is no ghunna inside. So this ghunna which is ikhfa, hided and added. We call it an harf far'i, that's the seventh one. And the last one, ikhwani, is al-mim al-mukhfah. Al-mim al-mukhfah, or in iqlab, in where we read iqlab, exactly the same time, we do them the same manner. When I look me, I am reading them, both read them the same manner. وَمَنْ يَعْتَصِمْ بِ I bring my lips a bit like this for mim, mukhfah, and I finish with that. You have to see your sheikh doing it. If you don't see, maybe you're going to waste long time to bring it. Can you bring it all together, please? وَمَنْ يَعْتَصِمْ بِاللَّهِ Again, please. وَمَنْ With me, it's no problem. وَمَنْ يَعْتَصِمْ بِاللَّهِ I can see your lips coming inside. وَمَنْ يَعْتَصِمْ بِاللَّهِ Don't press too much. Because I'm mukhfa, it's hidden. But don't leave any space as well. Because many, when small thing, one sheikh, he said, you have to bring forja, etc. And you create a big problem in the talabat al-ilm. Alhamdulillah, qurra, they meet each other, etc. They knew where it comes from. And he corrected. Alhamdulillah, that man, he said that he made a mistake, he returned back. But the problem, his books is many distributed, etc. And it's a problem. Small things, yani, is protected, subhanAllah, Muslim, don't let it pass in like this. The other one, fa'am, same thing of when you read it. Fa'ambatna. Barra akhra, Sheikh. Fa'ambatna. Bring your lips a little bit inside. Fa'ambatna. MashaAllah, I've seen some good practice on here. Jazakumullah khair. MashaAllah. So these are, ikhwani, hurufat, huruf far'iyya, subsidiary. Letters. Why we call them far'i? Why? Who can answer me? لماذا نسميهم far'iyya? لأنها مختلطة غالبا بغيرها. سواء مخرج مع مخرج أو صفة مع صفة أو صفة أضيفت إلى مخرج فأعطتنا حرف آخر. Why we call it subsidiary? Why we call it far'iyya? Because what? We? It's not أصلية. It's not originally there in that 28, 29 sometimes. Something to it. That's for you, as I told you. You need for you. And you have to format you say, now you make it TV with another sifa, not to give you a dolly or majri. originally in Arabic. Nearly finished. We from here, Ikhwani, we start really Tajweed. All what we read now is introduction. All what we read till now is Muqaddimat. We started, inshallah, from this part here, Tajweed. And we thought about articulation points with too many practice. And sorry for talking too much in this durus. But durus kami, inshallah, we start too much talking about makharij huruf. How to know the articulation point of a letter. Ulama say it's very easy. Just put sukun on the harf, bring hamza, which is the very far letter, which is hamza a, and bring sukun on that harf, put sukun on that harf, you know where it comes from. Where it's finished, that's the point of articulation. Easy for him, for ba, ab, so it comes from what? From left. And I have a nojah min shafatay. Kadaik mim. Look at the difference. Ab, mim, little bit. Your left is picking star. Can you touch it? It's there, is it? Huh? Yeah, well, Hamza itself. That's coming this empty space all the way until we finish it. That's huruf. All makharij are here. Makharij huruf are here in this order. You can put another order of Arabic like this if you want, but you don't want to. But the ulama, they knew it. They put some poem to make this order very now. Like this. It goes like this. Let's read them all together, please. I knew that's the beginning of. The first one is huruf al-mad are here. No, with the conditions. Before waw, you should have dhamma. Before ha, before ya, you should have kasra. Before alif, you should have fatha. Alif, every time, fatha before it. But ya or waw, it depends. Like Quraysh, I do have fatha before. Khawf, I do have fatha before. But alif, every time, fatha before. With the condition huruf mad, you should have before waw dhamma, before ya kasra, and before alif fath. That's in nuhiha, that's in Surah Hud. Nuhiha, can you say it? Nuhiha. Yalla, what is it with the hamza? It's better with sukun. Should be like this, but just we want you to see the point where it comes from. جزاكم الله خير وحسن الله إليكم. Let's practice little bit before we go home. Where you want to go home? We see, inshallah, if you can practice little bit. What we read last time, إخواني, we read Surah An-Nas. How we mix it with what? We mixed Surah Al-Falaq with Surah An-Nas, correct? Allah. The computer is not happy. Well, let's see the other one, maybe, Hisham. And we finish, inshallah, by practicing this. Maybe we'll do it together, and inshallah, next time we will ask you to practice better. Inshallah, in yassar Allah wa atala fi umri. We'll take it from this computer, it's better, inshallah. Where is the other machine? Your mabr, ikhwani, this is the muraja'a that we took last time. We finished surah. We got how many mothers to read the other one? Three. I said four. MashaAllah. That's three, four riwayat has, which is very common. If you got other riwayats, you'll use these 2 hours. Any mumkin other people, they can see us and you can watch us outside. So we have to tell them this sort of thing. This lucky riwayat worship, we can have this too. But riwayat hafs, which is more common and mainly read by many Muslims around the world, we go to these 3 manners. Yalla, let's take some examples. Fadla, can you read this? To read it, but as I told you, in general, Sheikh will tell you to read it or not. But for me, in general, every time read the Basmala, please. All the way out. Can you carry on? You know it by heart. Should be fis wa innahu la fisq. Look, see now, fis la fisq. Qaf is it? Correct. Matan wa bayyinatin min al amr. Correct or mistake?
Mistake.
What's the mistake?
Lan
Umar, Mim, Amr, and Rai make it all equal to Qalqala. Amr, al amr, al amr. Like this. MashaAllah, this is practice. Who can tell me theoretically what are they? How many case? When I read surah, I want to read next surah. How many? Thalath. Man huma? Ma huma? Yalla, over there, please. Inta mashaAllah, mujtahid. Hunak. Can you tell me what's the case? Anyone over there, please. Huh? Qat'u al-jami', you cut everything. You finish surah, you cut. Basmala, you cut. And you read next surah. Excellent. That's the first one here. You cut here, you cut there. قطعوا what? قطعوا الجميع. You cut everything. You cut the last ayah of the surah. You bring basmala. You cut. You bring the beginning of the surah. What the next one? Waslu? Waslu jami' is the last one. The order is very important, ikhwani. That's the order. If you take one, no problem, inshallah. But it's better to take it in order. But if you do another one, no problem. You did this, for instance, we prefer doing this, no problem. We prefer doing this, no problem. But that's the best. It's the best, for example, if you're reading for Sheikh, or you're reading for the paper, it's the best to bring the first one. If you want to do another one, take the second, it's best as well. After, yeah, it's after the first one. And the last one is this, to bring everything. What you call, this is Waslul Kul, you link everything. What's the cost called the second one? Qat'ul Awwal, you cut the first, and you link the second with the third. No problem, mashallah. Look, Ikhwani. Oops, Afwan. Same thing now. I want, inshallah, we this way when you want to go to practice, don't have any problem when you want to read the Quran in the reverse order. I want to read Nas, read Falaq, read Qul Huwallahu Ahad, read Tabatada, and so on. Is the same rule. Exactly the same rule. So what we can do? This one, no, don't practice this for this case. I'll take it off. This one here. So for Jamie, who can practice that? Who can practice? Yalla Shabab, one of you. Tadda. You, Shabab. Don't sleep. Yeah. Can you practice, please? I finish Nas, I want to read Falaq. How can I do it? Who's like this? Can you do it? Inshallah, we come to one time we will explain to you how you read the Quran. In the beginning, when you start reading in front of your Sheikh for the first year's time, you have to read slowly. Sheikh has to hear each harf one after one. If you can read like this, isolate them as Allah waratil Quran. You have to bring half by half. قُلْ أَعُوذُ We call it, Ikhwani, what? At-tahqiq. We'll talk about this, inshallah. At-tahqiq, you bring haqq to each harf, you give haqq to each harf properly, slowly. Sheikh will not miss anything. You read quickly when you are, mashallah, top. Maybe you dream, you read tajweed. You die, you read tajweed. Really, it comes well, like this. I've seen some people like this. Dying, reading Quran very nicely. Because it's tajweed, it comes and nabit. He can't read Quran unless he read it with tajweed. So now, please, if you ask someone to read, please take your Now, if we don't read it now, mashallah, you are a good excuse now. But now we read the slice. This is the slice. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب Inshallah, one time we will show you inshallah how to make, to mold, and to lead them. Inshallah, it will come. Don't worry, but now, now just take a long breath and do the maximum that you can.
So after the scene, correctly say the Bismillah.
Yeah, connect it. This is why you put it in color like this, it means connect them. What is color there, it means connect. قل الرحيم قل الفلق إخواني جزاكم الله خير sorry to keep you waiting too much today جزاكم الله خير أحسن الله إليكم إن شاء الله we practice next time إن شاء الله we start with this practice properly إن شاء الله تعالى سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك عمن الناس ومن ظلمنا أنفسنا فاغفر لنا فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت اللهم تقبل منا صالح أعمالنا وتجاوز عن سيئاتنا. اللهم جازي من أحسن إلينا يا رب العالمين، جازي إخوان أهل المسجد ومن أنفقوا في عليه ومن يعمره. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى يبارك في أعمارهم وأرزاقهم، وأن يصلح أحوالهم وأن يصلح أهليهم وذويهم، وأن يبارك فيهم وفي أرزاقهم يا رب العالمين. وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما، والحمد لله رب العالمين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وغالب حسب الوقت، إذا كان الشيخ عنده وقت والطالب مثلا عنده وقت، وغالب ما يستمرش كثير يعني. ما يستمرش
بهذا
الفصل يعني. This class normally is for 6 months. This class here is for 6 months. Inshallah, and we start to test the paper to see who is doing good, who is not. And if we see someone who is doing good, inshallah, we.
بالنسبة لهذا الورق. يجب أن نكتب الاسم.
مشكلة الولد أعطى كل واحد ورقة واحدة.
ما فهم قصة.